2023 Toyota Sequoia in the Capstone Hybrid Edition in the Celestial Silver exterior paint color. Beautiful premium interior look with that black and white coming together with the natural wood. And we're gonna be bringing you an in-depth video here at Vagabond Builds. Let's go ahead and show you this video. Now, as mentioned, we're gonna be talking about this exact 2023 Toyota Sequoia. But before we do, there's two buttons. If you guys do like our content, we'd like you guys to push, and that's the like button. Subscribe to our channel because it is not a sponsored video, and we truly appreciate your guys' support here at our channel. Also, if you got some for us to film, here's our email below. Email us, we could talk details later. A special shout out and a thanks to Maida Toyota here in Sacramento for providing us this beautiful Toyota Sequoia for this review. Also, keep watching, stay tuned. We're dropping that MSRP sticker so you guys get an exact idea of what comes on this car. Now let's go ahead and talk Toyota Sequoia Capstone Hybrid Edition. So let's kick this review off with talking some specs on this iForce Max engine. Now, it is a V6 3.5 liter twin turbocharged engine, but also hybrid 24 valve. Goodness, dual overhead cam. There is just so much going on with this iForce Max engine, but you're getting 437 horsepower. Now, that is a lot for this exact engine with 583 pounds-feet of torque, 10-speed automatic transmission with transfer case and automatic limited slip differential. That is going on. 19 city on the MPG, 22 highway with a 20 combined and a 22.5 gallon gas tank size, everybody. Now let's close this hood and talk Toyota Sequoia Capstone Edition. Get a load of this premium look with the LED lighting, the multi-step kind of dual eye LED lighting. You get that two level in those kind of like rectangular shapes. Beautiful daytime running light with the LED fog lights down here. Coming together in that celestial silver with the piano black look, that kind of black gloss. Beautiful in the metallic silver grill. Camera integrated here. You got the blue on the Toyota emblem because it is a hybrid. Bumper sensors integrated into that lower side of that front end. And finishing off with that, what we like to call those Texas rabbit whackers, but very cool and just very, I would say, grand, expensive look on this Capstone Edition. Get a load of the indentation in the hood, off-road look, but also, of course, prestigious. Coming over to this side, you got the iForce Max on the hood itself, letting you know what's under that hood. Dropping down, let's go ahead and talk some wheels and rims. They're running the Bridgestone Buellers HTs, and the size is 265 50 22 bicolor rim, machine surface silver in that kind of gunmetal gray look. Now this is all shiny and beautiful, new from the dealer. One thing I'd like you guys to point out is that this wheel well trim comes painted, giving it more of kind of a cleaner look, higher class, because a lot of times you'll see these black plastic wheel well trims. And yes, they are durable, those black plastics, but honestly, I like the wheel well trim the same color of the car. Look at the side of this beautiful Sequoia. Get a load of your cuts, your angles, your body lines. Let's talk some length, width, and height. Starting with the length, you have 208 inches. Width is 79 inches with a height of 74 inches. Ground clearance up to 9.1 inches if you have the TRD Pro, but of course, we are expecting that the low point of these new Sequoias is the rear differential, giving you also a minimum of 8.6 inches ground clearance on these Sequoias. Take that into consideration for people who'd like to know if you're going off-roading and things of that sort. Now, continuing forward, you have the mud flaps, Capstone emblem on the lower side of that front door, letting you know it is a Capstone hybrid. Up top, we have the side mirror in the dual color, the chrome, also with the integrated lighting in that black gloss look. You have the 360 camera system in the front, also here on the side, and this fully loaded mirror with blind spot assist, automatic foldable mirror. That is just the big bang, the biggest horse in the barn right here, okay? Now, keyless fob entry, dual color on the handle in the black gloss with the chrome. Chrome going across, roof rails in that kind of metallic aluminum brush look a little bit here, but also finishing off with that kind of chrome look. Very cool that. Loving how there's so much character to this car, but it's coming together very beautiful. And just remember, pay attention to the cuts. Goodness, beautiful car. And I'm a big fan of the Celestial Silver. It's a low maintenance color. Very cool. Now, coming over to the rear end LED, LED rear taillights. I was about to say fog lights, but let's start from the top. So we're looking at the spoiler. Spoiler has the integrated brake lighting system. Right under that is your rear glass windshield nozzle. Dropping down, of course, the windshield wiper. And if we continue lower, right next to this emblem, you have a little black button that pops open that kind of multi-tailgate option. Very cool. The blue on the emblem, letting you know it's hybrid. Camera system integrated right over the license plate. You can open the tailgate by the button right here. Sequoia going across, dropping down. You got the bumper sensors on the lower side of that rear end in that black gloss trim, right? Now, something I want to mention, you have multiple ways of opening this tailgate. You can open this tailgate by a hands-free system by kicking your foot. If your hands are filled with the kiddos or objects or you got the groceries, you can just kick that. You can open it by the button, and you could also open it by the key fob. So a lot of ways or multi-way of opening up this tailgate. Let's go ahead and open this tailgate and talk cargo area. So cargo area, minimum cubic feet of space, you got 22 feet, and maximum 87 cubic feet of space with both of those rows completely down. Now, let's go ahead and show you guys the ins and outs of this cargo area. Starting with the right-hand side, you have the two control buttons for your automatic or electric controlled third row seating. We could go ahead and drop those down. Just like that. And you can stop them and pick them back up. These seats also are controlled. You can move them forward and back by these levers down here, forward and back. And another cool thing that you have is like a shelf that you can put three different levels shelving. Maybe you got a camera, maybe you're trying to, I don't know, change your kit or something. You wanna kind of just use this. You can also use these dividers here, these plastic dividers, and clipping them right here, kind of giving you a little bit of separation on this lower plastic piece cover here. Another very cool thing is check that out. You can lift this up. Super cool option to have on these Toyota Sequoias. You see that in other trims as well. Now let's go ahead and put this back down. You have also an inverter, 120 volt inverter. If you want to bring an air fryer, hair straightener, I have no idea what you would bring that, but maybe you just want to camp with the air fryer. And the LED premium lighting system inside the car is beautiful. Now that we're pretty much done with talking exterior specs and some cargo area, let's go ahead and jump inside the interior. So before entering the car, something I'd like to mention, the car was off in the video, but I want to show you guys how cool this is. You have an option right here, a button on the left-hand side of that electric steering column, and you go ahead and pop these huge running boards out, and they're very wide. They come out very far, and you can literally turn those off, tuck them, and they will not be used, okay? Now let's go ahead and step inside this premium quality interior of this Capstone Hybrid Sequoia 2023 and just stop and get a load of the colors, the natural grain wood look, the white or the kind of off-white look coming together with the black, beautiful perforated look on these seats. Just amazing, okay? The rigid, the off-road, the luxury feel inside this car. Now, to bring this interior to you, let's go ahead and start with this door panel. Of course, the colors, you have a little bit of natural grain wood here, but your memory seating, up to two memory seating buttons here, control unit for your windows, and your automatic foldable side mirrors and controls for that too. On the left-hand side of the electric steering column, you have a lot of buttons. You have the lighting button for your rear end. Of course, you have the gas lid button, lighting buttons, dimmables for your dashboard, heated steering wheel, your AC 120 volt power button, and of course that button for your running boards. Just a lot. Steering wheel wrapped in that perforated look also kind of grainy up top and on the bottom. And that kind of off-white stitching, metallic silver with the black gloss. You have the cruise control to the right and your controls to the left that you can control that full digital 12.3-inch screen. Right behind that steering wheel, controls for your windshield wipers and your lighting system, all right? You can control that that cluster screen with your arrows here on the screen, but for the sake of time in the video, we're not gonna be doing that. Up top, 10.0-inch heads-up display, very cool option to have in this capstone edition, wrapped in that kind of beautiful leather feel partial dashboard. Rugged look on these vents in that silver leads us to the 14-inch infotainment screen. Now this is huge and this car is awesome for that reason. We're gonna have to subscribe for navigation. Wanted to show you guys that. Let's go ahead and show you guys media. Pretty reactive to touch screen. All right, so it doesn't lag right off the bat, trip information, all that good stuff. Shoot over to Meta Toyota here in Sacramento and they have guys that'll spend their time with you, okay? Dropping down, you have the Tri-Zone Climate Control module or the unit here. Now, dual up top, you can sync both temperatures for right and left passenger and driver. But look at these super cool knobs, rugged like off-road knobs. Beautiful knobs on that. Up front, you have passenger and driver heated and ventilated front seats. Okay, you can control that also. USB-A right over to the right of all these buttons. Dropping down, you have another control unit for your trailer system, your camera systems, 360 view. You could get different angles on that. Traction control and hazards. And one thing I wanted to mention to you guys that I didn't mention at the rear end, you got the trailer brake assist system and it can tow up to about 9,200 pounds give and take, which is a lot of towing for a Sequoia. Wireless charging pad. You have the parking brake button here with your automatic hold button, shift lever. This is where your toggle switch kind of control unit for your four high, four low, and two high going in and out of that. Drive modes, go ahead and go through drive modes. Sport, Eco, pretty much just three. We're gonna leave it at normal. And a tow haul button. Pop open that lid of that natural grain wood lid. You got nice big cup holders. Coming into the personal area here, you have USB-A, USB-C plug-ins, some change, I have no idea. The change holding, that's going out of business. More personal pocket room. And let's go ahead and lift this up, show you guys that kind of little cubby room with that slidable tray in that. Cup holders to the back of the center console that allows the back seats to have some cup holders. Up top, tilt and slide. Look at this glass, just beautiful look. Goes all the way over to the second row seating, but look how big and wide this glass is. Tilt, slide, sunroof option. Very cool. Remember, you will see differences in different trims around cars, but this being like the fully loaded capstone hybrid, you get a lot in this car. 14 speaker JBL premium sound system inside this car. Okay, now let's go ahead and finish off with the glove compartment. Simple, straight to the point. Now we're pretty much done talking about the front side of this interior. Let's go ahead and talk second and third row seating. Now second row seating, and get a load of this. Right off the bat, I want to bring to your guys' attention, look how wide these captain seats are. Huge. I think these are probably the most wide seats I've seen in a third row SUV. That is just phenomenal, okay? So you're getting a whole lot of comfort in this Sequoia with the adjustable armrests and the aisleway cup holders with some personal room for your belongings, right? Now, how to control these seats, all right? You have options, the levers here at the elbow, the lower elbow of these seats. You can bunny hop this forward just like that. So you open up the way to that third row seating, drop this down, lift this up. Now I'm about 6'2". The room in this car is phenomenal. Don't literally, you are not worrying about room, especially if you wanna drop the angle. You get head clearance, leg clearance. in front of these seats. You got pockets and on the back side of that center console. Another inverter, USB-A, USB-C plugins with your tri-zone climate control, and both captain seats on the second row are heated and ventilated. Very cool option. You also get the sun visors on the rear doors of this car and the same beautiful premium luxurious look coming from the front over to the back. Keep an eye out for that too. Now let's go ahead and bunny hop these seats forward. Step inside the third row seating. Let me go ahead and show you guys that. And drop this down, lift this up so you guys get an idea of how much leg room you have. Now, my head is completely touching the top. All right, so take that into consideration. Us taller people, it's gonna be a little bit more claustrophobic on this backside just because your head, but the leg room is there. And it feels like it's higher up, that you're sitting higher up than everybody inside the car. To the right and the left, you have buttons, of course, to control the angle of your backrest, and you can increase that head clearance by these buttons here too. So multiple ways to control these seats. Sun visors on the third row, which is very cool if you're being bothered. I have no idea how the sun would be bothering you back here, because literally you're like confined back here. Air, if you got animals, you got the kiddos in the back, whoever's sitting back here, you got air for here, and that true light lighting back here also, right? Some hooks, and that's pretty much it. But wanted to finish off on the left, you have, of course, the speaker system here. But what's different is on the right, you have a USB-C plug-in tucked away in this little personal cubby room. So that's pretty different also, okay? Now we are completely done with this review. As promised, we're dropping that MSRP sticker. Let me know what you guys think. Any comments, questions, concerns, leave in the comment section below. We'll try to get back to you guys as best as possible. Thanks, guys, for watching our channel here at Vagabond Builds. Stay tuned. We have more cool things coming. God bless you.